What is up, you guys? What a do? Welcome or welcome back to the channel. As you can tell from the title, today, this weekend, is all about my fall glow up. Your girl has been working a lot and just kind of going through the day-to-day stuff. It's like summer's over. Basically, it's over. Like, pumpkin is back everywhere. Labor Day weekend was last weekend, so it's kind of pretty much fall now. I decided, you know what, let's do a fall glow up, let's get our nails done, and do all the other things that I like to do to make myself feel, you know, nice and pretty and all that. So right now it is 10:20. I have a nail appointment in 10 minutes, but I, of course, had to stop at Starbucks, had to get a pumpkin cream cold brew, so that's what we're doing, and then, yeah, to the nail salon. I'm a couple minutes late, but I had to eat my breakfast sandwich, so. And we're back! Oh my gosh, y'all, I have not seen my hands have fake nails in so long, but, like, my confidence just rose a little bit, so I just went with this, like, very neutral brown color. It was from OPI. It's called appeared to be tan. And then I got this like little orangey color on my toes. No free toes, no free feet pics. So just take it. But yes, I love this color. It's like beautiful for fall, especially with my ring, my little gold ring. I love it. So I think I'm gonna run over across the way because there's a Marshall's over there, as well as a Old Navy. And Old Navy always has really good fall stuff. And I saw that they have, I think, $15 flannels. So I'm gonna run over there and do a little bit of shopping, maybe find a cute new fall outfit or something. I just love this. It's like so fall. It's perfect. It literally looks like a pumpkin cream cold brew on my fingers, so. Alright you guys, I just got over to TJ Maxx. As you can see, Marshall's wasn't a complete bust, but they didn't really have a lot of like the fall, I don't know, I just feel like they didn't really have any good fall clothes, or at least what I'm looking for. Old Navy was actually pretty good. I got two brown tank tops, I'll show you guys those in a little bit, and then a $15 flannel, which is why I went over there, was for the $15 flannels. But now I'm gonna run in here, hopefully find something, and then if not, I think I'll head home. But I'm having a good day. I'm enjoying my retail therapy.
Alright, just left TJ Maxx and Home Goods. Total bust. First off, it was just like really busy in there and I just didn't feel like dealing with that. And then I tried on a few things and they just all fit my body really funny. I don't know what's going on. So I'm gonna run to one more place because I keep forgetting it, but it's called, shit, I'm drawing a blank. The girls on Chins and Giggles talk about this place all the time. I'm literally drawing a blank. I've been there before. I just haven't been there in probably like 5 years or so. And we, not just recently, but more recently than not, we got one over near us, so I'm gonna go check it out. I'm totally drawing a blank, and I can't remember what it's called. It starts with a B. Oh, it's gonna bug me till I get there and figure it out. I did stop into PetSmart over here, because it was right next door, to get the dogs some treats, because they haven't had treats in like a month and a half. They haven't been spoiled, so they'll be very happy when I get home and give them that, but it's getting to that point in the day where it's like so hot, I don't want to be out. I just want to go home. Burlington! It's called Burlington. Yeah, I haven't been to Burlington in a long time, so I'm going to slide over here and check it out. I had to go back to the nail salon to fix one nail. It was super small, and I probably like pissed them off with how I wanted it to be perfect, but she did it, and she didn't complain, so it was just like my little pinky was missing a little bit of nail polish, so yeah. But I'm gonna run into Burlington. Last time I was over here, this Burlington was like overstock or something, so Burlington. Let's see what you got for me. Hopefully it's something good.
All right, you guys, it's about 2:15. I ran my last errand for the day. I did find a few things at Burlington, but I'll be honest, I kind of wasn't that impressed with it. I don't know. The thing with like Marshalls and TJ Maxx and Home Goods and Ross and Nordstrom Rack and Burlington, all those like stores, is they're just always so unorganized that it feels like it's like a yard sale, like trying to dig and find stuff. And this is very a first world problem, but it's why I enjoy online shopping, is because I don't have to like rummage through people's messes. But I did find two things there. I have to try on the pants because the fitting room was closed, so I took a gamble. And I was like, I hope these fit, so we will see when we get home. But yeah, I got a few cute staples for fall. And then a few beauty items. And I think I told you guys I went to PetSmart to get the dogs some treats. Not really part of the fall glow up, but, you know, if my puppies are happy, I'm happy. So I'm going to get home. I got to also freshen up. I'm like hot and sweaty and for some reason like sticky and... it's not there. Once I get home, I'll do a quick little haul of all the goodies I got. Also, of course, need to do like hair removal, like plucking my eyebrows, and I'm gonna probably like do some microblading. You know, an everything shower is definitely in my future.
All right, friends, we are home. I'm gonna show you all the goodies I got. First thing at Burlington, I picked up these D jeans. They're high waist skinny bootcut jeans, and they're in this like brownish orange color. These are the ones I didn't try on, so I hope they fit. But they just have like that little boot cut opening at the bottom. I really hope they fit because they're really cute and they were a really good deal. I got them for like $12, so we'll see. Hopefully they fit. And the other thing I got at Burlington was this American Eagle crew neck or like pullover sweatshirt, and it just says choose kindness with a cute little flower on it. I like American Eagle stuff. It fits me well, it fits my body, and I thought this was just a nice sweatshirt. So then at Marshall's, I picked up some gloves to do dishes with because I don't have a pair, and with me getting my nails done again and like probably gonna continue getting my nails done, I wanted to get a good pair of gloves, so when I do the dishes, I'm protecting my nails. So these were $5. They're just silicone cleaning gloves. Also at Marshall's, I picked up two hair care items. I picked up some dry shampoo. This is Foxy Bay No Fox Given Dirty Gal Dry Shampoo plus Biotin. It was $10. I've never heard of this brand, so I'm kind of taking a gamble, but yeah. And then the other thing I got was this Coco Magic 10-in-1 Leave-In Treatment. Kind of seems like it's like an It's a 10 product, just obviously not that brand. So it's always good to have some leave-in treatment, leave-in conditioner options. The other thing I got at Marshall's as well was this super cute festive pajamas. I'll be honest, you guys, I usually don't let myself buy a lot of the festive stuff just because it's very trendy and I feel like I can't wear these in March or January. Like these are wear now till like Halloween. I also got them in a bigger size just so they could be kind of like super loose on my body. But they're so cute. They have little skeletons and caramel apples and candies and bones, and they're like a super lightweight material, so it'll be really nice. And these were, I think, were $10. Yeah, $10. So cute. And the last place I went, which was the first place I went, was Old Navy. Just got three things there. Honestly, I went there for this, which is, by the time this video is up, the sale's over. But today and tomorrow, from when I'm recording this, their flannels are $15. So I went ahead and got a blue flannel just because I don't have this color. I have a like pinky brown flannel. I have a red and blue flannel, but I don't have like a blue and cream flannel. And I just, you know, I like to wear these with like a tank top underneath and just kind of open with some jeans. So yeah, I got that flannel, super cute. I actually really love it too with like my brown nails. Speaking of brown, I got two tank tops because the only tank tops I have that are brown are bodysuits, and sometimes it's just
if you have a long torso or if you have like girls that kind of stretch over the bodysuit, you know what's happening down there. It's like not comfortable. It's like riding up. So I wanted to pick up some tank tops that weren't bodysuits in brown. So these were $7 a piece. Again, I got them a little bigger just because I'm trying to, I don't know. I'm like, you know, growing and not gaining weight. I mean, I am, but like not like bad. It's not, I mean, it's just whatever. Like it's just, it's my life right now. And so I'm trying to buy clothes that are going to fit me long term rather than buying a size that's like a little too small and stretching it out. I'd rather buy a size that's a little too big and then kind of like let it shrink. So yeah, I got this brown color and then this light brown color, and these were both $7. So all right, you guys, we are at the last part of this video, my fall glow up. As you can tell, my hair is re-dyed. I did that a couple days ago. I just took an everything shower, exfoliated, shaved, moisturized, you know, all the goodness. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do some microblading on my face just to get some dead skin off and little peach fuzz, and then clean up my eyebrows a little bit, and then we're going to jump into doing some face masks. So the first face mask I'm going to do is the Kiehl's Rare Earth Deep Pore Cleansing Mask. I've used this multiple times. It's really nice. It doesn't dry me out, but I feel like it gets a really good deep clean. We'll follow that up with a nourishing face mask from Sephora, as well as the hydrogel eye masks. So my skin is going to be super happy after all of this. Okay, your girl is out of coconut oil, so we're just going to use some olive oil. Obviously, this is what works for my skin. I know some people could never put olive oil on their skin, especially if they already have oily skin, but I'm pretty blessed to have combination dry skin. I don't want to say blessed because in the winter months my skin is super dry, but of course when you are doing any type of microblading or anything like that, shaving your face, you want to make sure that you don't go over any blemishes or any open wounds. So I'm going to be really careful with this guy right here and maybe this one right here. And then another tip that I have, it's actually probably like the number one tip with microblading. Always, always, always use a fresh one of these. I know they can get a little pricey, you know, they're not too bad, but if you have to microblade often, it can kind of get annoying. But always use a fresh one. Don't ever reuse them. Once you use it, toss it. So when I microblade, I actually don't microblade my mustache because I prefer to wax that. You can, but I feel like when I microblade my mustache or my eyebrows, it grows back thicker. So I'm gonna go ahead and just pull up my baby hairs that I don't want to shave off, and then very lightly just kind of go down your face. Don't forget to go down your neck. You don't want to have a beard and then like a beautiful bald face. And pull back those baby hairs that you don't want to chop off. And then I usually go down into my eyebrows, but again, I don't like to cut my eyebrows with the microblade. So I'll just kind of shove all that hair and that dead skin into my eyebrows. And then of course, I'm gonna wash it out. But I just find this to be the easiest method for me. I really like microblading because I feel like I mentioned, I get dry skin, and sometimes the dry skin doesn't come off with exfoliating. So when I do the microblade, it kind of lifts that first teeny tiny dead layer of skin and pulls it off. And then of course, the little peach fuzz, but I also just really love how my makeup applies when I have a nice microbladed face. So I do this about every 4 to 6 weeks. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and give my face a good little wash, get off any of the dead skin that's still sitting on my face and any of the peach fuzz, and then I'm gonna put on the Kiehl's mask. I'm gonna put it on just a little thicker than I usually do. I've been getting a lot of clogged pores in this area, which I'm pretty sure is like hormonal, which love that, you know. Who would have thought I would have been in my mid-20s and still get acne. This feels really good. A big reason I like to use a brush when I apply a light clay mask like this is so I can get in all those like tiny crevices in my skin, you know, in the nose, and if you have any like sunken parts of your face, you can really make sure the mask gets penetrated in it. right, last step for my skin is going to be the face mask and the eye mask. Oh, it feels so good. Oh, wow, this feels so good. I don't even care if it gets in my hair a little bit. Oh. All right, and then a little tip is I like to like squeeze all the stuff that's in the package out, because usually they'll have some more. And I like to apply this to my hands and my neck. All right. Ah. Y'all, this one might be my favorite face mask that I've done from Sephora. It's like super, super moisturizing. After I remove the mask, of course, you gotta moisturize all that good stuff into your skin. And lastly, finish it off with a mesh. And lastly, finish it off with a lip mask so the lips are nice and moisturized as well. And then bam, that's all it is. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit subscribe. I have a lot of good content in the works, so you don't want to miss it. And yeah, oh, my skin feels so good. All right, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.